It's 1984, and amidst all those synthesizers, one classy outfit is bringing a touch of jazz to the pop charts.
That quiet, really intense, intimate sound. It was like Sade was in Sade's world.
She has it all. She has the looks, she has the sound, she has the talent. And she has a great band wrapped around her as well.
She was sophistication personified.
It was the late 1970s when Nigerian-born, Essex-raised Sade Adu moved to London to study.
She was a fashion design student at St Martin's and she had plans to be a fashion designer. She worked as a stylist for a while. She worked with Spandau Ballet. She was on that kind of early 80s club scene. She used to go to the Blitz Club, the big new romantic club.
That kind of very pared down, hair swept back, big earrings, red lips, that was the look that first caught my eye in the Blitz.
Robert Elms and Sade soon became an item, and that would lead to a fateful encounter.
One of my mates, a guy called Lee Barrett, he was managing a band. They needed a backing singer. And he said to Sade, I was sitting next to her when he said it, he said to Sade, can you sing? And she said, yeah. And I remember thinking, are you sure? Because there was no great evidence for this.
The band was called Pride, and although they never got signed, they did appear on TV. This incredibly rare footage, filmed almost 40 years ago, and which many believed was lost, gives an intriguing glimpse of Sade, the backing vocalist.
Even though she wasn't the lead singer, my eye went to her, like, who is this supernaturally gorgeous woman? Just like, all of it was just like, you know, just a perfect apparition of beauty.
Now, what happened was, Sade started doing more of the taking the lead vocals on certain songs. And one of those songs that she took the lead vocal on was a song called Smooth Operator, which was written or co-written with one of the guys from the band Pride.
When Pride disbanded, Sade took both Smooth Operator and several band members with her.
They went off on their own and became this band called Sade. I mean, her name was Helen Fola Sade Adu. But she was Sade, that's how she always introduced herself, and that's then what the band became called.
But pop star riches weren't immediately forthcoming.
I'm living with Sade in this squat in a disused fire station, which had an outside toilet on the balcony, which used to freeze over in the winter. When she writes, when am I going to make a living off the first album? No one was making a living.
While expensive studio time was way beyond the pockets of these North London squat dwellers, an opportunity arose in 1983. One which would see the band record their biggest global hit in their very first recording session.
Robin Miller is one of the great untold stories of that era, because Robin was visually impaired. He was going blind as he was making those records. And yet his positivity and his spirit and his ability to work with a lot of really untutored young kids was extraordinary.
I set up my own studio and used the free time in studios to invite young bands and saying, I'll produce you, but I want a share, you know, in your profit.
Wanting to make the best use of precious studio time, Miller opted for a recording approach which is unusual in the pop world.
I was giving them a little bit of free studio time, so let's write down everything we're going to do. And I mean literally write out the notes so that when we go in the studio, we're going to use the time efficiently. We wanted to get two tracks completely finished, Smooth Operator and Your Love is King.
Your love is king, crown you with my heart, your love is king.
What Robin would discover when the singer opened her mouth was that this was a voice in a million.
Round and round and round my head.
What I'd heard, of course, was what we all know now is that voice. That tone that seemed to come from 10,000 years ago.
She's just singing in your ear all the time. It's a beautiful sense of intimacy.
We gave the tapes to her manager, Lee, and he went round all the main record companies who all turned the music down. They said no. Why didn't you use proper drum machines? Why didn't you use synthesizers? Why have you got saxophones? And we were stuck, really.
But all that would change after one magazine cover.
Rob Elms was writing for The Face at the time, so he wrote a piece for The Face, and she was literally the face of The Face, which was the most influential style magazine of the era.
What had happened is, you have to understand, we'd seen Spandau happen. We'd seen Boy George happen. So it wasn't a great surprise to think that you could, if you say you can do it, you could end up on Top of the Pops doing it. And the very fact that you've seen this occur two or three times already with your friends leads you to think, well, yeah, if they can do it, I can do it.
Suddenly, the manager's phone started ringing by the same people who had turned the music down.
The moment had come for Smooth Operator, the song that dated back to Sade's days as a backing singer, to be introduced to the world.
Diamond line, lover boy, he move in space with...
It would be the opening track on Sade's 7 million selling debut album, Diamond Life, and the band's third single. And the recording that became a global hit was the one made in those very first sessions with Robin Miller.
When you're making a record, when you're in the studio, you have to do something that's as close to what you like as you can. The most amazing thing was to make a record, you know, to put our songs onto vinyl. I didn't think, God, is anybody going to like these?
People hear this rather sophisticated sound and assume that she must have written it somewhere in a fancy hotel. Nah, she wrote it in a disused fire station in Tottenham with an outside toilet. But it's a song of longing, of yearning. It's a song about kind of wanting to get out of a dump that you're living in and move into this other world. People portray the 1980s as if it was this incredibly sophisticated time. It wasn't. This is Thatcher's Britain. You know, we're all suffering from that. Well, you can either moan about that, or you can daydream of a different, kind of more sophisticated world. And that's what Smooth Operator is.
It's a song about a guy on the make, a smooth operator.
She's almost like a documentary singer. She's documenting the narrative as if she's a fly on the wall watching this guy go about his business. There is a very strong and obvious relationship between the saxophone and lead vocal in this song. Sax, it's a sexy sound. It can be sassy and sexy. It can be sleazy. And I think it's doing all of those things, representing the guy. This song is her talking about him. You'll notice that the lead vocal is heard, but then you have the saxophone playing at the same time, weaving in and out. That's very unusual. Normally, you have one focal point, which is the vocal. But here, we've got this saxophone just standing behind, but still playing an independent line of its own.
Smooth Operator would be the launchpad for a global career, breaking the band worldwide, including America, where it reached number 5. and almost a third of Sade's 60 million plus record sales since have been in the US.
In America, she is absolute soul royalty. All of those hip-hop artists, all of those new soul singers, they all kind of, you know, bow down to Sade.
Almost four decades into her career, Sade has remained an enigma, disappearing off the radar almost totally during increasingly long gaps between releases. But each time, returning to pack stadiums and sell millions.
With the exception of Adele, she has been worldwide the most successful British female in the last 30 years. Massive, all over the world.